of glass.
So that's part of the storyline. What's at stake in the Big 12 is part of the storyline. I think the other thing is it's an early tip. It's 11 a.m. here in Texas. This is what Oklahoma basketball tweeted out this morning. I think you and I sort of felt like this at 7 a.m. as we were starting to get ready for the game.
Yeah, I think I saw you fall, your head hit the pancakes this morning during breakfast.
Yeah, I managed to brush my teeth, though, and get ready for this one. But the question is, are the players ready? It's an unusual tip time, 11 a.m. local for these kids from the Midwest.
Well, your routine changes on a day like this with such an early tip. Teams normally have shoot-arounds or walkthroughs on the floor, get some shots up, break a sweat. But today, neither team did that. Oklahoma just stayed in the hotel, slept in a little bit, had some breakfast, and came over to the arena just a little bit earlier.
Well, Baylor, in its basketball history, has never beaten a number one ranked team. They have a chance to do that today. Oklahoma's got the ball to start the game.
And here you see Baylor coming out in their zone defense. They play 50% zone and 50% man on the season.
Cousins dribbled into a three and hits the first shot of the game.
And that's a little bit of the danger in playing zone against this Oklahoma team. They are the best three-point shooting team in the country at 46%, and it comes from multiple guys. It can be Cousins, it can be Woodard, and it can be Heald.
Number one in the country over the top, Torian Prince. Nice set play for Baylor.
And I like the pass by Ish Wainwright. Wainwright second on the team in assists. Delivers it right on the money.
Lots of different weapons for Oklahoma, and many of them also for Baylor. Spangler skipped it over to Heald. He used that dribble but missed the three. A rare miss for Buddy Heald, who's just been spectacular shooting the ball all season long. Prince, the runner's good.
Well, we talked about it in the open already. Points in the paint is going to be crucial tonight. How is Oklahoma going to limit Baylor from there?
They left Woodard wide open, and he may not quite be Heald in terms of the percentages, but he's close.
But this is what I like from Oklahoma on the offensive end. They are getting to the gaps of that zone defense. It's a little 1-3-1 right now, and they are getting their shots from the slot and then from the corner there.
Well, so far, I don't think the 11 a.m. start time has impacted anybody, at least on the offensive end. Shots are going in. That's Al Freeman, who's a good shooter. Kadeem Latin managed to keep Gathers off the offensive glass.
In this zone, there has to be great communication from the Baylor Bears players. I see a lot of guys pointing and talking already.
Woodard, same spot where he hit a shot just moments ago. This time the defense closed out on him, forces the jump ball. That'll be Baylor basketball.
Good job of swarming to Woodard. Woodard had a chance for just a one dribble pull up, took it one dribble too deep right there, and that caused the double team.
And I do think you brought up a good point right away. Can Oklahoma shoot over top that zone? One thing Baylor does do pretty well, gets out in the zone and challenges three-point shooters.
Well, they really do. They have great length at each position on the floor, except for maybe the point guard spot, but Medford is very quick and can cover a lot of ground.
Oklahoma themselves have been traditionally a very good defensive team under Lon Kruger. They force a turnover. That's a travel on Freeman.
And also, for anybody that hasn't seen Oklahoma play this year, they really made a change in their lineup during the offseason. They put Isaiah Cousins as the point guard this year, and he's coming off his best game of his career at Iowa State, where he had 26 points. He had been in a slump. He makes 4 for 5 from behind the arc, and now 2 for 2 tonight.
So that's the thing for Cousins. He's handled the point guard duties. He can still shoot the ball, though.
Yeah, and he's much improved. His freshman year, he only shot 25% from behind the arc, but he's been up over 40% in his last 3 years in a Sooner uniform.
Number one team in the country on the road. Wainwright open, no good. Gathers his first offensive rebound. Lost the ball, though. And now maybe Oklahoma an advantage. Heald attacks. Heald got fouled. And I think they say a non-shooting foul. Well, he's been around a long time. Fifth year at Oklahoma. Had success everywhere he's gone. One of the best coaches in college basketball, Lon Kruger.
Truly one of the best. And I was fortunate enough to be recruited by Lon Kruger. Florida was actually in my Final Four. And is the only other place I took a trip to besides the University of Arizona. I went to the Final Four my senior year of high school with the Meat Hook, Dimitri Hill, Andrew DeClerc on that Florida Gator team.
Hoping to bring this Sooners team to the Final Four. They have an excellent chance. Woodard, three, way off the mark. Here's Lester Medford, who has been playing at a very high level for Baylor. That pass deflected, almost stolen by Cousins. Down low, Wainwright was fouled. Kadeen Latin reaches in. That's been a problem for Oklahoma. Young player, just a sophomore. When he's on the court, he's been very productive. A lot of foul trouble for that guy.
Yeah, Latin has really given him tremendous minutes. He leads the Big 12 in blocks per game. He's getting 3.5 blocks during conference play. Remember, they lost Tayshaun Thomas, who was a big key for this team last year, could score in the post, was a good rebounder, but they really haven't missed the beat. Latin got stronger over the offseason. More of a defensive impact than offensive end.
Freeman couldn't get the three off. Both T.J. Maston and Jonathan Motley, two real productive players off the Baylor bench, into the game early. Here's Motley, who was fouled. We talked about Lon Kruger. On the other side, Scott Drew, who has been the best coach in the history of this Baylor program, doesn't get enough credit for the job he's done here in Waco.
I mean, he really brought this program to life when they were just hanging by a nail, maybe almost nearly facing almost like a death penalty type of sentence 13 years ago. He's been to the Sweet 16 three of the last 6 years, two straight NCAA tournaments, put guys in the NBA. Truly remarkable job done by Scott Drew.
Yeah, the story's been told many times, but it's hard to understate what a terrible place the Baylor basketball program was in when he took over. And here they are, a perennial power in the Big 12. They've been to a couple of Elite Eights. And developing guys like this, Jonathan Motley, who has started to really emerge, missed the second free throw, rebound healed.
Right now, if I'm Oklahoma, I don't want to get too jump shot happy. I still want to make sure I get inside of this zone. Even though I have some wide open threes, continue to look diagonal, but I might have to put the ball on the floor a couple times, get in the paint.
Well, Cousins was trying to do that. Shot clock starting to wind down. There's Latin. Nice look to Woodard. Reverse layup. Good. Beautiful offense.
Great ball movement all around. It went side to side a couple times. The zone was very active, but Latin in the high post had a lot of composure and looked diagonally to the cutting Woodard.
And just what you were talking about. That's their first two-point attempt. They got to the rim and scored. Freeman was open. The three is good.
What a cross-court look by Lester Metford. This guy is fifth in the nation in assists. That's 7.5 assists per game. Beautiful skip pass.
We saw the defense swarm on Buddy Hield. Latin tried that same type of pass. Not as good of a look this time. Here come the Bears.
Because Latin's not really a threat at the high post, they just backed off and played the passing lane.
Maston down low. Motley was, no, not fouled. He committed the foul. Well, that goes against Jonathan Motley.
Well, the Sooners doing what they do best. They get the ball inside there, the little reverse lay-in to give them the lead. And then the answer on the other end, Al Freeman with the knockdown three-point shot.
This exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Phillips 66, proud sponsor of Big 12 basketball.
Dave Fleming, Miles Simon back here in Waco. What's trending in the Big 12? Well, it is tough going for everybody. Not any different this week, huh, Miles?
Yeah, well, that was a heck of a game Monday night in Ames, Iowa. Oklahoma hit 17 threes in that game and still lost on the road. Tough to win at Hilton Coliseum. Then Tuesday, we were there in Stillwater where Oklahoma State, a star was born that night. Juwan Evans was an absolute stud in that game, dominating performance. And then kind of an ugly game on Wednesday, but Texas and Shaka Smart are kind of imposing their will. They're playing much better basketball. West Virginia goes 8-for-23 from the foul line at home.
As of right now, Joe Lunardi's got two of the number one seeds from the Big 12, both Oklahoma and Kansas. West Virginia on that three line along with Iowa State. 7 of the 10 teams in this conference in the field as of this morning, according to Joe. Oklahoma ball out of the timeout. Buddy Hield wide open. That shot's going to go down almost every time.
But that was caused by Isaiah Cousins. He took one dribble into the gap, didn't even get that deep, and drew two defenders, which left Buddy Hield wide open. Mistake on the rotation defensively by the Bears.
So you see the three-point shooting already for the Sooners. 5 field goals made total, 5 assists for Oklahoma as well. Torian Prince, little jab step, tried to answer. Woodard rebound.
I think Baylor has to continue to try to establish themselves inside like they did on the first two possessions of the game. That's a contested three that they shoot on that one.
Latin up top, Cousins to Spangler. Had a tough night on Monday in Ames. They're looking for a bounce back game from Ryan Spangler.
Yeah, and I don't think they'll have to worry too much about Spangler not being consistent. He did have a tough game on Monday night, but this is a senior who's played a ton of games. He has struggled from behind the arc. I think he has to see that ball go through the hoop here in the first half just to kind of get his rhythm and confidence back.
Still averaging a double-double on the seasons. Cousin three, no good with the shot clock winding down. King McClure, a freshman, off the bench for Baylor. Ahead to Medford, who will now run the offense. Aston trying to enter it to Motley. That was a good catch, contested shot. Good defense by Latin.
Well, the best thing Oklahoma's doing right now is they are keeping Baylor off the offensive glass. Baylor, one of the best offensive rebounding teams in the country.
Ryan Spangler threw it to the scouts.
Now, he was a quarterback in high school. Now, I don't know if someone was going deep right there, but you got to keep it within the green lines, and he just airmailed this one.
All right, it's one thing. Okay, you want to impress the NBA scouts. I'm not sure throwing them the ball is the way to do it. He was a high school quarterback and a good one. He started his college hoops career at Gonzaga when Lon Kruger took over in Norman. Came back much closer to home. He's been a very good player for the Sooners.
Wasn't offered by the previous staff.
And how about Spangler into the passing lane? Nice steal. Three on two. Woodard up top. Cousins. He traveled.
And I don't like that break right there. You have a three on two opportunity, and Woodard kicks it out for a 3-point shot where Keel ran to the three but didn't shoot the basketball. You got to get something at the rim, start getting inside. That will soften up the defense if you can get some things at the rim.
I think it's a good point you make. We know they're the best three-point shooting team in the country. We know Buddy Hield is the best three-point shooter in the country. That said, you have a chance for a layup. Take the layup. They do lead by six here. Still early in this one. Early in the morning, early in the ball game. Prince, couple dribbles, tough shot. Motley on the offensive glass, good.
If you don't get physical against this Baylor team on the offensive glass, you're going to have a long night.
Hield, one dribble, scores.
Perfect pass there by Spangler. You see the other pass didn't really affect him or worry him from taking that one.
King McClure from three, the freshman who started to play much better.
McClure has been shooting lights out from behind the arc in his last three games, 6 for 10.
And it's loud. Spangler not even looking to shoot. He was open. Latin missed the shot. And a nice tip from Motley to Gathers. And Ryan Spangler, he was 8 feet away, just turned and hit that shot. Motley down low, tough entry pass. Medford was swarmed by Cousins out of bounds. And that will send us to a timeout here in Waco. Maybe the best player in college hoops, Buddy Hield. If you don't know that much about Buddy, we're going to tell you about him, his name, when we come back. on Oklahoma star Buddy Hield. Where did the name Buddy come from? His family gave him that nickname based on one of these gentlemen, Buddy Holly, Buddy Guy, the blues legend, Bud Bundy from Married with Children, or, hey, could even be Buddy the Dog from Air Bud. Well, you get four choices. Where did the nickname Buddy come from? Miles, do you know the answer? He is your buddy. You and Buddy Hield are pretty tight.
I do not know the answer. I'm going to assume it's not Air Bud and it's not Bud Bundy. I'm going to go with Buddy Holly on this one.
Okay, good guess. The answer, though, Bud Bundy from Married with Children. I think it was his aunt who was a fan of the show and decided that with the big smile as a little kid, that's where the nickname came from. That's a true story.
David Faustino. That was Married with Children. That was one of my favorite shows growing up.
You're diving deep into this. Look at the numbers for Buddy Hield. Second in the country in scoring. The only player who's scoring more than him, James Daniel from Howard. So of all power conference players, Buddy Hield far and away the top scorer, over 26 points a game. He's got six games of 30 or more. He's just been tremendous.
Yeah, I talked to Coach Scott Drew after practice yesterday, and he said, I don't know if there's anyone I respect more than Buddy Hield because I know how far he's come.
That kid, King McClure, who wasn't playing even just a few weeks ago. He was deep on the bench. All of a sudden, he's become one of the best scorers off the bench for Baylor.
And look at this zone. It's active. It extends. They're catching the ball at about 27 feet from the basket. Have made five passes and haven't really got to the three-point line.
Hield had it knocked away from behind. A great lead pass. McClure, one step. And Baylor leads. Freshman to freshman. That was nicely done. Dante Buford, a freshman who's been playing well off the bench, had his shot blocked by Prince. Lindsay, who's a good passer, young player. They think he's going to be really good. Nice look from Motley. Gathers offensive rebound. McClure scored 7 points in the last minute and a half. Trying to add to that. And another offensive board for the Bears.
Well, Oklahoma's trying to make it a physical contest, and they're going to lose that contest to Motley with his length and Rico Gathers with his strength underneath.
Undefeated at home this year, Baylor. That one came up way short.
And then against this zone right now, they're going to need to screen the zone, even maybe an on-ball screen. The passing is not working because Baylor's rotations are very tight right now.
Denzel Walker. Not a real deep Oklahoma team. He's one of the few who gets significant minutes off the bench. Buford missed the shot. Spangler got a hand on it. But Gathers comes up with the board.
You know, it's a really interesting move that Scott Drew trusts his zone defense against one of the best three-point shooting teams in the country. But you can see it's solid.
Gathers, a little too strong on the free throw line jumper. Well, now that Bears offensive rebound game starting to come to life.
Just got pushed right underneath the hoop by Motley there. Got to be tougher.
Spangler, this time he does shoot way off.
Now Oklahoma looks hesitant against the zone.
They do.
Buford didn't know to shoot the last one from 15 feet. Spangler's wide open from 7 feet. They don't know where the rotations are coming from, and everything's getting contested.
An 11-2 run. They're really making a point of getting the ball to Motley. Nice skip, McClure. I think he had a chance to shoot the three. Instead, Hield commits the foul. That's his second. And that's big news and not good news for Oklahoma. King McClure has provided a spark off the bench, Miles.
McClure, just 6 or 7 months ago, wasn't supposed to be playing basketball. Here he gets the steal, the back tap, and now the lay-in. Spark off the bench for Scott Drew and his team.
He had a heart condition diagnosed over the summer, and they thought that perhaps King McClure's basketball career was going to be over. And he had a procedure where he's got an implant to regulate his heartbeat. Prince off the inbound. Good. They left him open. A 12-0 run. And Oklahoma wants a timeout. It's alive in Waco. Quick break. We'll be back right after this. Simon in Waco, Texas, where Baylor's trying to knock off a number one team for the first time in their program history. Shots like that from Prince.
Well, the thing that's getting it started, though, has been the defensive end of this Baylor team. And after giving up some early wide open threes, they have active hands, they're moving their feet, they're pointing, they're talking, and Oklahoma has had no answer.
And now their star, Buddy Hield, is on the bench with two fouls. Spangler along the baseline, dribbles right by Motley. Nice move.
That's the most aggressive move that they've made in the last 3 minutes. Spangler with a lot of confidence right there. One hard dribble, gathered himself, and the nice lay-in on the other side.
And that ends the 12-0 run. Baylor's lead is four. Medford spins and double dribbled. A rare turnover for him. He's protected the ball.
Yeah, in his last 15 games coming into today, 117 assists and only 44 turnovers. He's almost the most important piece for this team. He's hit two game winners, one in the last minute versus Vandy, and then the last second shot against Texas Tech already this year.
And you talked about Cousins moving to the point guard spot. That's Woodard three. Good.
And Scott Drew's letting Torian Prince know that he backed off too far against Woodard right there. They were covered up on the baseline, and you can't leave a guy that's as good as Woodard from behind the arc. 53% on the season.
Medford was the starting shooting guard for most of last year with Kenny Cherry still in Waco. This year he's been the full-time point guard. He's been real good at it. His three. Banks in! I don't know about that one. Counts for 3 points anyway. See if Oklahoma can use that passing. Buford one dribble against the shot blocker.
And see, that was a slight adjustment that Kruger and his staff made in the timeout there. They get the ball to the high post. Instead of those guys hesitating, now they're being aggressive. And he took it right to Motley's chest.
Aston over the top. Not a good pass. Stolen by Oklahoma. Here come the Sooners. Nice look. Walker had nowhere to go with the ball, though. He got sort of turned around. So that'll send us to a timeout. The three-point shots on both sides have been aggressive.
Well, first it's Jordan Woodard. You give me space, and I'm going to knock it down. And then Lester Medford says, I got your answer, young fella. Be you. Up two.
There's the buzzer, and we have the winner. It is Ben. Congratulations, Ben. You are the winner of the
All right, and thanks. Well, Baylor trying to do something they've never done today. 0-6 all time against AP number one ranked teams. Two of those previous six have come here to Waco. How about Phi Slamma Jamma? Look at Clyde Drexler and Akeem Olajuwon back in 1983. Kansas, Rafe LaFrance, Paul Pearson company were here in 1997. And here this afternoon, Oklahoma on the road, the number one ranked team in the country. Woodard out of the timeout. Another three for Jordan Woodard.
And just getting the ball to the short corner to Spangler has sucked in the defense just enough to leave Woodard open for his last two threes. Baylor's going to have to do a better job and adjust to that.
That puts Oklahoma back in front after the big run from the Bears.
And remember, Oklahoma doing this with Buddy Hield on the bench with two fouls right now.
Medford dribbling through the defense. Again, had nowhere to go with the ball. Almost turned it over. Shot clock winding down. Al Freeman. Freeman's got to shoot, and the defense just let him shoot. Gathers was fouled.
When you're trying to block out on the weak side against a guy like Rico Gathers, you almost have to just face guard him and move his body out of the way, because Rico Gathers is so strong. 6'8", 275 pounds, all muscle, but he does a great job of positioning himself opposite of where the ball is shot nearly every time, and that's why he gets four offensive rebounds per game.
He's got eight rebounds already in this game. Oklahoma as a team has five.
It's amazing what he does on the glass, and that's why you could almost see there might be a spot for him in the NBA, because there are guys that are just rebound machines that are undersized, like Gathers.
He counts as a rebound machine. That guy, TJ Maston, counts as a low post scorer. He's got some nice moves.
Double digits in three of the last four games for Maston, the young man from DeSoto, Texas.
Here's Woodard. Baylor's got to pay attention to him. Jordan Woodard has 11. A lob. I don't know what that was.
But see, Latin's in a position where he's not comfortable having to be a playmaker. He has to be a finisher against the zone.
Ish Wainwright on the perimeter.
Go back to Mastin if they can get it. Mismatch on Woodard.
They're trying to get him the ball, just haven't been able to do it.
Good switch back by the Sooners.
Now the screen from Mastin. Medford lost it. Woodard against the defense, scores with a foul. What a half for Jordan Woodard.
Well, the defense created the active hands by the guards there of the Sooners as Cousins and Woodard team up right there. And then I love the attack, and I love the jump stop. Too many times you watch in college basketball, guys always want to do a Euro step on the break. But here, because you jump stop, you get more body control and can absorb contact better like Woodard did there.
Three-point play completes it. Jordan Woodard has 14 of Oklahoma's 29 with 4:45 to go. And with Buddy Hield on the bench, he's been the guy who stepped up.
Well, what an improvement as a shooter. He shot 25% from behind the arc last year. This year, up to 53%, one of the best in the country.
One of the biggest improvements I can ever remember.
Well, we talked to Lon Kruger last weekend about his shooting adjustment. He did a lot of form shooting this summer where he took a little bit of a hitch out of his shot. He has a much more fluid shooting motion now.
I would say it worked.
To say the least.
Buford had it knocked away and stolen.
Good hands by Wainwright on the backside.
Jake Lindsey. Freeman almost traveled there. Lon Kruger wanted the travel call.
Lindsey's going to be a good guard in this league. Very big. He's a good passer.
Good assistant. Yeah, that was Woodard who helped out, stripped it away. And now Cousins draws a foul. Well, Oklahoma, since that last timeout, they've been on the attack. And the Sooners, the top-ranked team in the country, with yielding foul trouble, back up by two. All right, Adnan, thanks. 29-27, top-ranked Oklahoma with the lead. That game that Adnan's just talking about in East Lansing, Maryland, and Michigan State. And the Spartans are desperate for a win. 6:30 Eastern on ESPN. Maybe desperate's too strong of a term, but Michigan State's kind of lost their way a little bit.
Yeah, and they need Denzel Valentine to almost play at an All-American status and play every game because he's not getting help from the other guys. But I like this Maryland team. I think Maryland is... they're one of my top four teams in the country, and Mello Trimble has been tremendous for them. And it's a team that can cut down the nets in April.
Isaiah Cousins, who's a good free throw shooter, missed them both. Now that's unusual. Two high-quality teams in the Big 12 here today. Prince, too strong. Mastin hustled and tracked down the offensive rebound. Nice look from McClure, so Prince will try it again.
Better job by Spangler on the second opportunity. They got lucky. Prince had two good looks. Spangler gets the block out the second time.
Buddy Hield still on the bench, had those two fouls, and Oklahoma's played pretty well without him, so Lon Kruger keeping him on the bench. There's Buddy. 5 points, two fouls, and yet the Sooners on the road are up by two. We're talking about your top four, Miles. Maryland, one of those top four teams. Your other three?
Yeah, I like North Carolina, and this is in order. I think North Carolina is the best team in the country right now. Oklahoma has been playing tremendous basketball. Obviously, their only two losses. And I think I got to give a lot of credit to SMU and Larry Brown missing nine games. His team is showing a lot of fight, a lot of toughness, as is this man, Jordan Woodard, right now. On fire from behind the arc. Now 4 for 5 from the three, 17 points for Woodard.
17 in the first half with his star teammate in foul trouble. Man, what a game already with a long way to go. And Oklahoma's back up by five. Now Baylor's offense has bogged down a little bit. Mastin had a good look, missed it. They're going to call a foul on Oklahoma going over the back.
Well, one thing that's really effective against this Baylor zone is diagonal passes. And there you see Latin, who has three turnovers on the night. He put some nice juice on that pass. He delivered it on time and on target right into the shooting pocket of the hot-handed Jordan Woodard.
And how about this one, Miles? Oklahoma's made 12 field goals. They have 12 assists. So there's been a lot of good looks in the first half. Really good passing team. Fresh shot clock for Baylor. That one almost stolen. Cousins does steal it away. He'd been really active on defense. Again, he pitches it out for three. Another one for Woodard. My goodness.
But what a great job by Cousins. Not only to steal on the defensive end, but he didn't rush on offense. He had a chance to shoot the layup. He kept his head on a swivel. His eyes were up the whole time, and this is one of the biggest reasons they switched him to point guard this year. He is the best passer on this team. And instead of running in transition, he's handling the basketball, the good hands, the steal. And then, look, he has his eyes up, and he sees Woodard right there. And he delivers a chest pass 20 feet away, right in rhythm to Jordan Woodard. This is beautiful offense right there in transition for the Oklahoma Sooners, and they almost do it better than anyone in the country.
Well, and two parts of that position switch. Cousins plays the point guard, and Woodard with that improved shot has been a great find at that two-guard position. The 9-0 run has been all Woodard. He scored all nine. And look at the numbers in this game.
And the position switch, it didn't happen in the summertime or last spring. It happened the first week of practice in October. They saw it with Cousins and Woodard, and it's amazing how seamless the transition has been for Cousins and Woodard to flip-flop positions. Cousins feels comfortable because he played point guard in high school at Mount Vernon High School, where he was very successful.
Woodard, the junior from Edmond Memorial High School just outside Oklahoma City. He has been the star in the first half today, that's for sure. Whistle against Kadeem Latin under the basket. So that'll be his second personal. We'll see if Lon Kruger sticks with him with 2:01 to go until halftime.
Well, I think they can bring in Buford for Latin. Buford has given them quality minutes the last couple outings, and here he comes.
Yeah, I think they have to. But Kadeem Latin's been the defensive presence underneath the basket. They got to protect him for the second half. Medford trying to get it in. The turnovers for Baylor, they've been a little sloppy with the ball. Credit the Oklahoma defense.
Right now, I think I want to get Jonathan Motley a touch, maybe in the low block if I'm the Baylor Bears.
They tried to get it to him. It's another turnover. And I think it was Woodard who got a hand on that pass. Oklahoma's defense has been really impressive. Buford, baseline, good.
Shot that one with much more confidence. And it's the diagonal passes that are going about 20 to 25 feet. They're extending Baylor's defense out. And then Cousins with the great look. Look, he's at the near half-court line. That's about a 30-foot pass right on target to Buford. And he was right in rhythm. He was coming off his best game in a Sooner uniform. 14 points versus Iowa State. He went 4-for-4 from behind the arc, the redshirt freshman.
So 14 field goals. They're shooting 67% in the first half and 14 assists. So they're getting good looks. The shots are going down because they're passing the ball so well, as you pointed out several different times. And then they've been impressive on this end. Mastin attacks, had it blocked by Spangler. That's a foul, though. And apparently there was contact to the head, so there was a lot of ball contact as well.
Spangler upset about the call. He thought he got all ball.
Now two free throws for a sophomore who's really been making his free throws, 22 of his last 24 at the line. Misses that time, though. Saturday night, brand new NBA Saturday primetime on ABC, and that starts tonight. And it's a good matchup. It's also an interesting one with everything that's going on with the Cavs. Bulls, Cavs, 8:30 Eastern on ABC. We're very excited about that new Saturday prime package in the NBA.
And what a heck of a game to get on the first night.
No kidding.
With the coaching change, Blatt, and then Tyronn Lue, who was a great player in this league himself when Nebraska was in this league.
He was. You're right about that. And now an NBA head coach, and one with a lot of expectations right away. Buford, three. That one off iron. Rebound, Medford. Baylor trying to push. Medford, nobody stopped him.
Smart. One of the best ways to ignite a break is have your guards rebound. Medford does that in that case and goes coast to coast.
Spangler from the free throw line, no good. There is a tiny difference between shot clock and game clock. We'll see if Baylor wants to hold. Medford does not hear Scott Drew. Now finally he gets that message from the bench. No 5-second violation now, as long as you get the dribble active. That's a rule change. There goes the shot clock winding down. Medford, they call an offensive foul. He hooked the defensive player. Scott Drew can't believe it. His second personal. Now it gives Oklahoma a chance with 6.3 seconds.
And if I'm Lon Kruger, I think about putting Buddy Hield back in the game here for the last 6 seconds.
There was not a lot there.
No,
I can see why Baylor
was
upset. Now that's not a good call. I'm with you. Buddy Hield's still on the bench. Just 5 points for the top scorer in the country of power conferences. Woodard, who's been the stud. Woodard, tough shot, no good. And that's how the first half comes to an end. A first half that was dominated in large part by Jordan Woodard. Man, was he tremendous with his star teammate Buddy Hield in foul trouble. Woodard had one of the best halves of his Oklahoma career. 37-30, the top-ranked team of the country with the 7-point lead. Adnan Virk, LaFonso Ellis. It's the Jeep Halftime Report.
Unbelievable how quick they make you pay. Buddy Hield gets 7 points per game in transition. And anytime you're in trouble, if you're the Oklahoma Sooners, it's always great to have the leading candidate for National Player of the Year on your side. Kadeem Latin finds his partner, the quick catch and shoot, and then the steal, and then the transition, and the knockdown three for Buddy Hield.
6 point lead for Oklahoma, 6 points in 22 seconds for that guy, Buddy Hield.
Well, here's the beauty of his shot. He shoots the same shot every time. Look, the shot preparation, the hands are ready. He has great lift. His feet are set. He holds that follow through, which helps him get great arc in the shot, and then the beautiful rotation as he shoots the ball with the seams.
Freeman had it blocked from behind, out of bounds. Baylor will keep the basketball. So Baylor had tied the game, and two threes from Hield later. It's a 6-point advantage.
And for Buddy, that just comes from tons of reps, being in the gym, and it becomes muscle memory. And what seems like maybe a tough shot for the normal college player is an easy shot on the move for Buddy Hield.
Limited in the first half because of the two fouls. His head coach kept him on the bench for the final 9 minutes of the half. Justin Medford's not been a great game for him. He found a way to flip one up there. No good. He's playing so well lately. Just not real sharp today. Cousins, three. Good! It's not just healed.
No, and that's where they kill you.
Because it's four different guys on the floor, including Spangler, that can knock down shots from behind the arc. You can't just leave one guy or key in on one for the Sooner team.
That's how you get a 9-0 run in a minute. Three threes. A foul on Oklahoma, so Medford will shoot free throws when we come back. The Sooners trying to get through this challenge from Baylor, up by nine. Back here in Waco, where our Wendy's Wooden Watch firmly on Buddy Hield, maybe the favorite for the National Player of the Year Award. Look at the shooting percentages for Buddy Hield. 51% field goal, 52% from three, 90% from free throw. You look at the top level of basketball in the NBA, they have what they call the 50-40-90 club. If you shoot for a single season, 50% from the field, 40 from three, 90 from the free throw line. Only six guys who've ever done that in any single season. It's some of the best players in the history of the game.
It's just a ridiculous list to be a part of, and for these guys, these are all guys that are going to be in the Hall of Fame in the NBA, in the NBA circles, and for Buddy Hield to be doing this at the college level, it's such an exclusive thing to do. It shows you what a special shooter that he is. He's not just a great scorer, but the time that he's put in, he wasn't a great shooter coming into college out of high school, but the repetitions, we know about the work ethic, the time he puts in before and after practice. When you're hanging with Nash, Nowitzki, Miller, Durant, Price, and Bird, I mean, that is unbelievable company. And Steph Curry's on the verge of doing it this year while averaging 29 points per game. John Barry and Pash brought it up on the broadcast last night. But he is a special, special shooter, and that's what's going to get him to the NBA.
And that's the 50-40-90 club. Right now, Buddy's in the 50-50-90 club, which is even more ridiculous. We're talking college versus NBA, sure, but just a demonstration of how good the shooting's been.
Yeah, only six guys in NBA history have done it
for a single year.
And the fact that Buddy Hield, when teams play man-to-man, he's facing every team's best defender and getting contested on nearly every shot.
They're basically not guarding Ryan Spangler, Baylor.
You got to put it on the floor, one dribble.
He knocked over Rico Gathers, which isn't easy.
Well, he was right. He's hesitant. And that's what he did in the first half a couple times. But the times that he was aggressive and made a smart play right away when he caught the basketballs, when Spangler or Buford or Latin were at their best in that bottom part of the zone.
Third foul on Ryan Spangler. Texas, Kansas follows us. That game got a little more interesting this week with what Texas did. Prince to the free throw line area. Torian Prince. Maybe he can start to get it going a little bit.
Yeah, I got to spend some time around Torian Prince this summer at the Nike Basketball Academy, where he really impressed going against guys like Ben Simmons, Chris Dunn, Buddy Hield was there, George Niang. He's put himself on the NBA radar.
He struggled shooting the ball this year. To some degree, Cousins finds Latin along the baseline.
That's been the soft spot all night against this zone. But when Latin and Spangler have been in catch-and-shoot or Buford in catch-and-shoot situations, Oklahoma's been much more effective.
The shots go in. The crowd gets a little quieter. They're trying to help their Bears beat a number one team for the first time in Baylor history. Freeman, three. Offensive rebound. That's what Rico Gathers does with the left hand. Couldn't finish. Oklahoma dodged a bullet. Hield, pull up three. Not this time.
And I think that's one facet that Buddy's been better at, not taking forced shots. He's been much more efficient. That wasn't a good look.
Wainwright wide open. Hield got fouled going for the defensive rebound. Foul against Torian Prince. Well, after our Pac-12 matchup tonight, Arizona Cal. It's a big game in the Pac-12. Sports Center at night. John Buchagras, Steve Levy will be with you on ESPN. It'll also stream live on Watch ESPN and the ESPN app. All kinds of stuff to talk about. Tennis, hoops, hockey.
And Oklahoma Baylor.
And Oklahoma Baylor. This will be featured this game. The number one team in the country. Of course, it was what? About 6 hours after they were officially number one that they lost, which it was no shame. You lose in Ames against Iowa State.
And it really wasn't an upset, only by ranking, because Iowa State was favored in that basketball game.
Spangler from that free throw area. He's got to take. If they're not going to guard him, he's got to take that shot.
And I like that. He faced up. He took his time. Saw what the defense was giving him. So I'm going to take this open 15-footer.
Baylor very impressively went to Ames and beat Iowa State earlier in conference play. Mastin.
Good rotation.
Medford, short, rebound, Sooners. Woodard finds heel, nice look, three, good!
Come on. How good is this guy?
So good.
I mean, the quickness of the release, he runs to a spot up in the corner, and it's nothing but net. You don't think that he's going to miss when he shoots the basketball. That's how good he's been this year. I mean, it's ridiculous what he's doing.
Biggest lead. That pass was tipped and out of bounds off of Oklahoma.
And let me put it in a little bit of perspective. I talked to Coach Scott Drew yesterday after practice, and I said, who have you seen in this league that is doing the things that Buddy's done? The two names that came, Kevin Durant and Michael Beasley.
Good company.
Elite company. Elite company.
With the foul trouble in the first half. Look, we watched Steph Curry last night in that incredible performance again for him. I'm not saying Buddy is Steph Curry. I'm not saying he will be at the NBA. But watching a college game with him, it's that same kind of feeling where as soon as he shoots, you just don't think he's going to miss. Freeman, runner, too strong. Motley, offensive rebound, then put it on the floor. Nearly lost it, still loose. And Heald comes away with the ball.
And that was Motley's mistake. He put the basketball on the floor where the Oklahoma guards could dig in at it.
Woodard was the star of the show for Oklahoma in the first half. It's been Buddy Heald. That's a nice play by Freeman. Prince almost had it stolen by his teammate. Lindsay fouled by Woodard. No basket. Foul on the floor. Second foul against Jordan Woodard.
So now if you're Baylor, you've given up open shots on the defensive end of the floor. Now what's your answer going to be on the offensive end of the floor? Motley's been good as of late, but I want Torian Prince to assert himself a little bit more, be more aggressive. He is their best and most talented player.
There he is for three.
He's more than capable of taking over basketball games. Had 30 points here against Vanderbilt.
Baylor's trying to hang with the outside shooting. Oklahoma 12 of 18 from three on the road against a good team. Latin from that baseline area. That's the second one he's hit. Kadeem Latin, one of the most improved players in the Big 12. And there are a lot of guys in that category.
They can play Lindsay as a driver. Not a great three-point shooter.
They came out and double-teamed him. He tried to beat the double team. Now it's a breakout for Buddy Heald with the left hand and a foul. Buddy Heald putting on a show here in the second half.
While the defense leading the offense, the big fella Kadeem Latin finding his partner. Buddy Heald takes the contact and the sweep. Figure roll.
Alongside LaFonso Ellis, I'm Adam Van Berk in our college basketball studios. Georgetown and UConn, here's LJ Peak for three.
I love the way he plays the game, steady and smooth.
Hoyas and Huskies locked up in a good one. And just a friendly reminder coming up next, it'll be Perry Ellis and Kansas. The Jayhawks are hosting the Longhorns. As you can see, Ellis so far has had a fantastic season, and Texas has had issues on the road. Dave, back to you.
The reminders are always friendly for Madman, aren't they?
He's the best.
He knows no other way.
And his time of the year is coming up with the Oscars coming up, too.
I have to say, Madman, a little shaky on some of your award preview tweets this week. I'm not 100% on board with the movie expert at ESPN. We might have to have a little discussion about that at some point. Buddy Heald completes the three-point play, averaging 26 points a game. You mentioned Michael Beasley, one of those guys that Scott Drew compared him to in terms of impact. That's the Big 12 scoring record for a single season. Heald is right there with him. Prince rejected by Latin, and Heald saves it inbounds. Cousins went right by Freeman with the dribble. Isaiah Cousins.
And now everything's just free-flowing for Oklahoma. Latin active on the defensive end. The Sooner guards have sat down in a stance, have taken away the straight-line drives and made things a lot tougher on the Baylor Bears on the offensive end.
23-6 run. This game was tied at 41. And Oklahoma has just exploded since then. And I'm glad you pointed it out, because it's not been all offense. The defense has also been really, really good.
No, actually, Oklahoma's one of the best defensive teams in the Big 12. They lead in field goal percentage defense. I see Buddy Hield moving his feet well enough to keep Torian Prince outside of the paint. And then you know you have the shot blocker behind you. And now, because you've made threes, Al Freeman has to close out longer to Isaiah Cousins. The beautiful sweep through and the one dribble J was nice and easy for Isaiah Cousins.
Well, Buddy Hield, who came back for his senior year, and Oklahoma is reaping the rewards.
For two summers in a row, I've got to spend time around Buddy Hield at the Nike Basketball Academy. And this summer in particular, I asked him, I said, why did you come back to school? And he mentioned the individual stuff that he got feedback from the NBA about his ball handling and being more efficient. But the biggest thing that he said, I want to win a Big 12 title. I want to end Kansas's streak, and I feel this is the team that can do it. And on top of that, I want to get to the Final Four and try to cut down the nets.
Medford bounces it to Freeman. Hesitated a little bit on the three. That's a tough shot. Latin got a piece of it. Motley foul on the follow attempt.
Boy, I like Kadeem Latin.
He
wasn't doing these things last year, and I know his minutes were limited because Tayshaun Thomas was there, but Kadeem Latin improved his body, got a little bit stronger through the shoulders.
Look at his anticipation. He waits till the ball is out of Al Freeman's hands. No body contact, then gets a piece of the hand on the Motley one, but great anticipation by Latin.
You mentioned Tayshaun Thomas. That's where I think this Oklahoma team, look, they missed the offense from Thomas. He was a good offensive player, good rebounder. I think this team has a little different dimension with the way Latin is playing as a rim protector.
I think I'm with you on that, because Latin is, he's a little bit more mobile, a little bit more athletic than Thomas was. And then I also think for this Oklahoma team, the way Buford is coming around now, they're getting a little bit more production off the bench. Dinjo Walker is playing better minutes. And if Christian James can find more of a three-point stroke and get some minutes, they're going to be tough.
Spangler came up short on the three. Baylor needs to get it going now. Freeman attacking the basket. Offensive foul.
And look how all the Oklahoma players, all four of them, go over to Ryan Spangler. That's a team right there. He takes that charge, takes it right to his chest on the drive by Freeman. He's outside of the arc of the four-foot restricted area. But then all four of his Oklahoma teammates come over to help him up and give him a hand. I love seeing that.
I tell you what, we've still got 10-plus minutes to go. Oklahoma is looking like the best team in the country here today. Baylor is good. Cousins, runner, also good.
But now the energy, I don't like the energy and the body language from this Baylor team. I know they're a little bit deflated, but you don't want to quit while you're out there. I mean, Isaiah Cousins almost went in slow motion right there and got all the way to the rim with no resistance.
Only one timeout left for Scott Drew.
They got to get Motley a touch. He wants the ball in the post. They missed him last time.
Trying to get it to him. Shot clock winding down. Medford. Here's Prince. One dribble. Tough three. Good.
Great separation. I like that from Torian Prince. Almost needs to demand the basketball every time down the floor right now.
He's got 15. Spangler finds Buford. That's the young guy you've been talking about. Not that time for Buford. Medford against Hield, no good. Motley had a hand on it, couldn't secure it.
Baylor been in the man-to-man the last few possessions.
I think they just had to change something up. Oklahoma was destroying that zone defense. Extra pass, Walker corner, three.
It's amazing now the confidence that when Hield and Cousins and Woodard are making shots, it's kind of infectious for everybody else on the team.
Motley underneath. Can't come from this far behind, though, trading threes and then you get twos. That doesn't work. 13 of 21 from three-point range. Can't trade buckets really of any kind. McClure almost stole it away. Rico Gathers will come back in.
They've really done a great job of limiting Rico Gathers. He only has two field goal attempts on the night, no points.
It's a guy who averages a double-double on the season. He's been doing his job on the glass, but just hasn't been able to get the touches nor convert when he's had them.
Plenty of time on the shot clock. Isaiah Cousins. Back to Spangler. That three is good. You're right. It's infectious.
Yeah, and that's the most improved part of Spangler's game. They got blood on Al Freeman's elbow.
Biggest lead of the day for Oklahoma, and so much of their offense always comes from outside, but this has been an impressive shooting display here today.
Well, the threes have been raining down for the number one three-point shooting team in the country, and it's come from all different guys. Buddy Hield, we know he can do it. He makes over four per game. Jordan Woodard held him in the first half. He made five of them there. Buddy Hield again in transition. And now you can't lose them again. They just run to that three-point line. It's like a magnet for this team. Then the ball movement, the extra pass, and then Joe Walker. And then Ryan Spangler, the big fella, capping off the high pick-and-pop play with another one.
Spangler, Walker, Cousins, Hield, Woodard. They've all hit threes for Oklahoma in this one. 26 assists. Now, they are generous here in Waco in terms of giving out assists, but still, what a number. 26 assists on 27 made field goals for the Sooners. With 8 minutes to go.
But you know what? That's a mark of a champion. A team that can win it all because they share the basketball and they have multiple weapons, and then they defend you.
King McClure contested two. Spangler defensive rebound.
And then here in the second half, Baylor, usually a team that's dominant on the offensive glass, has not been able to impose their will on the offensive glass.
Hield. Good.
Special. That's the best word I can use to describe him. It's not just the catch and shoots there. It's the ball handling. A little bit of creation of separation there. And the easy pull-up.
That's it. That's the last timeout for Scott Drew. It was still 7.5 minutes to go. Can they figure out that guy? I don't know if they can. 74-53 Oklahoma. Well, it is a weekend and a week upcoming. We're going to see a lot of those players. That's Chad Ford's list of top 10 prospects in college hoops with a notable omission in terms of the NBA. Motley draws the foul. He'll go to the free throw line at top 10 list. Where's Buddy Hield?
Well, he's not on there. And then here's the question. This is what the NBA values. Potential, because that's all you're basing Scal LaBissiere's NBA future on, because his production has not been great.
to say the least, in college. And Buddy Hield has been a dominant performer for the last 2 years at the college level. Now, the NBA is just looking at Scalabissier's size, the fact that he can shoot some face-up jumpers, but he has a rebound of the basketball well, and you know, Buddy Hield's almost punished for being in college for 4 years. Now, he's going to play in the NBA and probably be drafted in the first round, but that's just kind of what the NBA looks at now.
It is a demonstration of the differences. Shot clock winding down here for Oklahoma.
But, Dave, here's how it's changing a little bit.
Spangler, another three for him.
Guys like Steph Curry.
Yep.
Klay Thompson.
Yep.
Draymond Green.
Okay. Keep going.
Tim Duncan. Those guys spent a lot of time in college. And those are guys that are playing on the winningest teams in the NBA right now. And that's why Buddy Hield's going to be valued by a great organization or great organizations like those.
Freeman three, no good. Gathers couldn't get the offensive rebound, but he was fouled from behind by Buford. And you see how the three-point line in the NBA, I mean, it's been important for a lot of years, but more and more important. And you figure Buddy Hield, we've seen the unlimited range. He's going to be a three-point shooter at the next level, too.
Yeah, and can you imagine Buddy Hield being able to play with, and I'm just going to say, a guy like even like Chris Paul or Steph Curry, that, or even play with Draymond Green, the way he can pass the ball, the open shots that he's going to get, and the efficiency and the high rate that he knocks him down at is tremendous. And he's going to be a total value to a team. You know what you're going to get from Buddy Hield day in and day out. He's going to be a guy, one of the first ones to the gym, one of the last ones to leave. He's a high basketball IQ guy. And you just know you're going to get a solid basketball player and an even better person for the community every day when you get Buddy Hield.
First 2 points of the game for Rico Gathers. There's nobody who, not just will say a bad word about Buddy Hield, the people in Norman just absolutely love the guy. They love everything about him. And you can see why. He plays the game with a lot of joy, smile on his face, and his teammates, I think, feed off that.
Yeah, and Baylor just looks lost defensively right now.
Yep.
And it hasn't really mattered besides about a 3 or 4 minute stretch in the first half where the zone was really effective. But Oklahoma's found their rhythm from behind the arc, and everything's just flowing.
Good hedge by Spangler. What great hustle.
Prince, too strong. Oklahoma gets the rebound. Yeah, Baylor's going to have some questions to answer after this game, despite the fact that they came in as the 5-1 team, the first place team in the Big 12 Conference with some really impressive wins. But plays like that just give you an idea of how this game has gone.
Well, the reason that that worked is you have Spangler popping, and Motley was going out to Spangler before the ball had left the point guard's hands, and that's a bad shot by Medford.
Here's Prince for three. Off iron. Buddy Hield comes away with a rebound.
The difference is on both ends.
Huge.
Oklahoma is shooting wide open shots. Baylor nothing but contested shots.
This has been a really impressive performance from Oklahoma.
And now they brought out the triangle in two, something they used against Iowa State a couple weeks ago.
Too little, too late. Walker. Not that time. A rare miss for Oklahoma. I mean, really, it seems like just about everything's going in. Freeman with the left hand. That was a nice move.
And I know this hasn't been Baylor's best performance, but this is a team to reckon with in this league. It's very hard to win on the road in this league. Baylor's already done that at Iowa State for a second consecutive year. They will win a lot of games, and they'll be a dangerous team when the NCAA tournament does come around.
Only team in the last couple seasons that has won in Ames. Baylor have done it twice in a row now. Spangler travel.
It is a team that has tremendous balance. In the main play, they have six guys that average in double figures. Lester Medford, maybe one of the more underrated point guards in the league, and I know he hasn't had a great night tonight, but he has been very good. I think Torian Prince can be more of a dominant presence on both ends of the floor for this team. He can rebound. He's a guy that's capable of averaging a double-double. Rico Gathers, we know, is a monster on the glass. He's better around the basket this year. It's just not Baylor's morning or afternoon.
Lindsey attacks, missed, out of bounds, off of Oklahoma. On the Oklahoma side of things, I mean, look, this is the number one team in the country coming off a loss, but a loss at Ames against a top 15 Iowa State team. Their other loss in triple overtime at Fog Allen against Kansas, a top 5 team. So that, I mean, the resume is really, really impressive. And you think they've got those two games out of the way, this game in Waco out of the way. It's not that it ever gets easy in the Big 12, but I think Oklahoma's got a nice schedule down the stretch.
They really do. I mean, you knocked out three of the toughest road games in this league within your first 7 games, and you win one of them. You take Kansas down to the wire. You take Iowa State down to the wire. That bodes well for Oklahoma in the month of February and trying to end Kansas' streak.
Nearly a record-setting shooting game for Oklahoma. Healed. you're shocked when it doesn't go in. Mastin slowed up, so he'll shoot the jumper. Motley, nice tip.
Motley's going to be a fine player, probably an all-Big 12 guy when it's all said and done, especially when he's active. His post moves have gotten better. He's a better finisher around the basket this year.
Spangler, Lindsay rebound. Well, the points have to come real fast. Nice look from Wainwright. That's a two.
TJ Mastin played on a high-powered AAU team with guys like Austin Grandstaff, who's going to be wearing an Oklahoma uniform next year, Matt McQuaid, Elijah Thomas. Mastin actually hit a game winner against my AAU team 2 summers ago.
Not that that's still lingering inside you at all. You're not taking it personally at all.
I'm not competitive at all.
Here's a three for Jordan Woodard. Motley tipped the rebound to his teammate. Not a good pass from King McClure. Turnovers have been a problem for Baylor.
Yeah, and especially tonight because Oklahoma's made them pay nearly every time that they've turned the basketball over.
16 turnovers for the Bears. Well, you're a team that offensive rebounds the way that Baylor does. Just get a shot up, and you got a good chance of scoring.
Yeah, for Baylor, a lot of times their best offense is just getting an offensive rebound.
Yep.
And that hasn't been happening tonight.
Under 2 to go. Oklahoma dominant on the road.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Phillips 66, proud sponsor of Big 12 basketball.
Texas Tech. This would be Devin Williams is stealing the finish.
You got to be able to handle the basketball against that full court pressure. Devin Williams throwing it down.
West Virginia with a 6-point lead. Dave Miles, back to you guys.
All right, Adnan, thanks. Big game for West Virginia, trying to bounce back from what I thought was a shocking loss at home against a much improved Texas team, the team that follows us in Lawrence.
Well, a big missing piece down there for Texas Tech as Odiasi is going to be out for Texas Tech, one of their best post players, and have them go against that physical front line that West Virginia has.
We'll break out for Baylor. Lindsay lays it in. You and I will be in Norman on Tuesday for Texas Tech on the road against Oklahoma. Any chance that the Sooners are still the number one ranked team in the country?
Yeah, I think there is, because it's no shame in losing on the road at Iowa State in a game you were not even favored in. And I know North Carolina's creeping there, and they'll probably end up getting the ranking just because of how people normally vote. But Oklahoma, I think they should stay number one.
Well, tonight, 6:30 Eastern on ESPN. One of those teams that has an argument, Maryland, trying to go on the road. A huge win against Michigan State. Journey to the Tourney presented by Sonic, 6:30 Eastern on ESPN.
I'm really high on Maryland. Yeah. I love Melo Trimble. And Diamond Stone, he struggled through about the first 3-4 weeks of the season. He's coming off the bench. He was one of the most highly sought-after recruits in the country. But he has been an absolute stud as of late for the Maryland Terrapins. And you had Cenk Lehman in the mix, and I think they're a team that can get to the Final Four and possibly win it all.
A lot of weapons. They've been up and down. They have not been a real consistent team. We'll have to bring it tonight. You know that East Lansing will be rocking. Oh, what a performance by Oklahoma. Bounce back after the loss in Ames against a good Baylor team. Not a good play. Oklahoma's been real sloppy in these final minutes. McClure with the foul.
And why would James even foul right there? And Odoms and James are kind of going at it. I like Jordan Woodard getting the two young fellas together right now to kind of get on the same page.
So a free throw coming for McClure. Makes the three-point play, 12-point lead. It's a 12-0 run for Baylor. The final score is not going to be totally indicative of the way that this game was played. Final few seconds, Jordan Woodard, the one starter still on the floor for the Sooners. He was huge in the first half, quiet in the second half, but with Buddy Hield in foul trouble, Jordan Woodard saved Oklahoma.
Yeah, he really did. Buddy Hield sat out a majority of that first half, and Jordan Woodard knocked down threes against that zone to keep the Sooners in the lead.
Shot clock violation, so that'll be Baylor basketball. Buddy Hield, a player of the year type performance in the second half, that's for sure for him. Lindsay drives, dishes. That'll be the final bucket of the game. But Baylor still has never in its history beaten the number one team, Oklahoma. An impressive road win by 10. And in the second half, it was a bigger victory even than that.
Well, you can see what makes this Oklahoma team so dangerous. It's not just Buddy Hield. They have multiple weapons. Jordan Woodard, Isaiah Cousins. Great performance to come on the road and pull out a victory in the Big 12.
So will they stay number one? We'll find out in a couple days. But nice job by Oklahoma. They win by 10. For Miles, Dave Fleming saying so long now to the studio. Adnan Burke.